Alright, so we're here with the second video with all the changes coming in year 4 and the year 4 roadmap. If you missed the first video, link card will be up there on your right. That's covering all of the new gameplay changes. This video is covering all the new features coming in year 4. Also, quick reminder, test server goes live tomorrow. That's Monday the 18th and not Tuesday. So go ahead and preload the test server now. But yeah, we're going to start off with the new features coming, and I guess we can start off with the test server. So the test server is going to be extended to 3 weeks instead of the regular 2 weeks before the launch of a new season, so they can get more player feedback and putting more fixes before the launch of a new season. So when the season launches, it launches as smooth as possible. So I'm going to start off with something that everyone wanted. Ranked is actually going to be moving out of beta after 3 years. So here are the changes coming to Ranked. First of all, pick and ban is actually coming. Yes, everyone wanted it. I didn't want it, but after playing the road to SI and actually playing around with it, I love the pick and ban system, so pretty glad that is going to be coming to Ranked. They're also introducing something called the new Ranked Hub. This is something that you would have only seen on the website, but now you can actually get it straight in the game. So on the menu screen, you can click on Ranked Hub, and here's where you'll see your stats, your history from previous seasons, what you need to do to improve so you can get to platinum. They also introduced the skill tab, which is the entire population and where you fit in among all the ranks. So that's pretty cool. And lastly is going to be the map tab. This is going to be telling you which maps are in the current rank pool, which ones left, and which ones are going to be coming. And also on the menu screen, seeing that we're going to pass 50 operators now, they're actually changing up the operator screen. So they've introduced something called the new operator album. And this is where you go to customize your operators and unlock them and all that. So on the main screen, you're going to see your two main operators that you use in the left and right. And you're going to see the attacker tab and the defender. So when you go in, you're now going to see everyone displayed and like their pictures instead of actually seeing the whole person. And this looks a lot smoother and it also looks a lot better. So I really like this change. And staying on the topic of operators, in the video I did earlier this week saying that DLC operators are now going to be cheaper, they're calling it the operator life cycle. So basically, the longer the operator has been out, the cheaper they will be. So the newer ones are still going to be at 25,000 renown, I think 600 credits and $5. And if they've been out for 36 months, which has been like I think pretty much the year one operators, they're now going to cost $10,000. $2 US, and I can't remember how much are 6 credits, but yeah, point is they're gonna be a lot cheaper. So I love this change, and this is gonna be better for the new players coming to Rainbow Six Siege. And speaking of the new players coming to Rainbow Six Siege, they've also introduced a new playlist just for those people called the newcomers playlist. So in this new playlist, you'll be able to join this only if you're level 50 and under. If you're over that, you're gonna have to go into regular, casual, and ranked. But the features for this new playlist is gonna be 3 maps: Bank, Cafe, and Consulate, I think. And only 1 game mode, which is gonna be Bombs. The attackers will be able to vote on where they want to spawn together, and the defenders, you're actually now going to be able to see which point you're defending, so you can pick which operators suit that point best. And these changes will also be coming over into casual game mode, so attackers can now pick where they want to spawn, defenders are going to see which spawn point they have to defend, so they can pick an operator to suit that point. And everyone was asking for it, so they actually changed the action phase timer. So casual playlist is no longer going to be 4 minutes, it's going to be 3 minutes 30 seconds. And they're making all these changes to kind of reflect rank, so you know what you're getting into. So these are also all good changes. Well, not all. I see 2 things that they didn't really mention that I would have liked. The newcomer playlist, you can go all the way up to level 50, but they didn't say about changing the ranked entry level. So you can stay in the newcomer playlist to level 50, but you can still go in ranked at level 20. I think they need to change that to also level 50 or higher. And also Smurfs, I mean, there's no real way to tackle Smurfs, but yeah, I can see a lot of people with new accounts who already get out of the game just going in the newcomer playlist for, you know, shits and giggles and, you know, fucking up all the people that are new to Siege. So yeah, that's kind of the one downside. And lastly, they've also hired a full team to deal with toxicity now, so they're gonna have a full team monitoring everyone 24/7. So they'll be looking at team kills, reports, people complaining for other people. So hopefully we see a lot more bans being given out to those toxic people. So this, in addition to the new team killing change, I think is gonna make solo queuing a bit better. So after hearing all these changes, I'm not dreading going back into ranked solo queue, because I know all these changes are gonna be there. Again, TTS goes live tomorrow, so go preload it. But that is the end of this video. So if you found this helpful, you can leave a like and comment down below. What are your thoughts on these new features coming to Siege in year 4? And don't forget to watch the other gameplay videos. Subscribe for more Rainbow Six Siege content, and have a lot more videos coming out covering all the new content, so make sure you subscribe and stick around for that. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.